Today I'm going to show you how to do the rifle rolls. Rifle rolls are one of the most impressive maneuvers that you can do with an aerobatic plane. Additionally, gaining some level of proficiency at performing rifle rolls will be a huge stepping stone towards learning rolling Harriers. During a basic rifle roll, the airplane is rolling at a very high roll rate while maintaining a constant altitude and direction. Taking this one step farther, the pilot can direct the plane into loops or circles while performing rifle rolls. If you are aiming for Jace Dusia's roll rates, with full aileron throws and max throttle, rifle rolls become extremely difficult. The cool thing here is that for those that are not Jace Dusia, you can pretty easily tone down the level of difficulty simply by reducing the throttle and reducing the aileron deflection to a more manageable level of roll rates. Before tackling rifle rolls, you definitely need to have a good handle on point rolls and slow rolls. As a recap on this, in order to keep the plane at a constant altitude, you will use rudder when the airplane is in knife edge, and use down elevator during inverted flight. In between knife edge and inverted, you will use a bit of both rudder and elevator. The closer to knife edge, the more rudder. The closer to inverted, the more down elevator. I often see people struggle to figure out what the correct direction is for the rudder inputs. Here's a simple way to make sure you always nail your rudder input directions when you are doing rolls. When you are starting upright, the first rudder input should go the opposite way of your ailerons. Subsequent rudder inputs will be the opposite of the previous one. So let's say you are rolling left. You kick in left aileron and nudge in some right rudder, followed by a touch of down elevator, then left rudder. Now, if you are starting your rolls from inverted, the first rudder input will be in the same direction as your ailerons. In either case, once you do the first rudder correction, the rest is easy. You just keep going back and forth. No need to think about left or right anymore. Simply focus on matching the next rudder input with the next knife edge position of the plane. The basics of rifle rolls are basically the same as those in slow rolls. To do this maneuver, start at around 60% throttle in horizontal flight. Go full ailerons to one side, and compensate with rudder and elevator as needed. Rudder and elevator should be moving back and forth constantly. If you are doing it right and keeping the plane stable without altitude or direction changes, the rhythm of your rudder and elevator inputs will stay pretty consistent, but your eyes will be the ones ultimately guiding the timing. The roll rate of your plane will determine the level of difficulty. At the beginning, I'd recommend reducing the aileron throws to a point where it takes about 2 seconds per roll. This is fairly slow and will let you focus on hitting your rudder and elevator inputs at the right time, without feeling totally overwhelmed. If you have access to a simulator, you can just reduce the physics speed to the point where you are able to link multiple rolls without changing altitude or direction. From there, start increasing physics speed in the sim, or aileron throws in your real plane, to boost your skills just a little bit at a time. You can also increase throttle to get the plane to move faster, which will increase the airflow in the ailerons and speed up the roll rate. Remember, you want to be at the point where doing this requires a lot of concentration, but you still can be precise and successful most of the time. With repetition, that speed will start to feel easier, and over time you will be ready to increase the roll rate a bit more. As you keep getting better and better, and you increase the aileron deflections more and more, make sure not to go past 38 degrees. At that point, if you keep going, you will encounter that the ailerons start behaving more as an air brake, and the roll rate of your plane will actually start slowing down. Sometimes people ask about the idea of doing rifle rolls with just aileron and elevator, so basically not doing any rudder correction to try to simplify things. The idea is that the plane rolls fast enough that you could get away with only correcting with elevator and no rudder, and avoid the airplane losing direction or altitude. I do get where these people are coming from, but I don't think this is a good idea. A properly executed rifle roll where you're using rudder and elevator will always be more axial and look cleaner than one with only elevator. You will definitely want rudder and elevator when you start making direction changes, like loops or circles, while performing rifle rolls. If you only used elevator, you would not have enough tail authority to move the airplane quickly and smoothly. More importantly, if you get good at performing rifle rolls with rudder and elevator, even if the roll rate is not that fast, your flying skills will improve dramatically. Slow rolls, loops and circles with integrated rolls, and any other rolling maneuver will become much, much easier. Transitioning to rolling Harriers will be a breeze, as you will have already mastered rudder and elevator control during rolling maneuvers. If you look at any of the top pilots, you will see that all of them consistently use both rudder and elevator during their rifle rolls. This is a tricky one. This is going to take a lot of hours to get right. Don't be afraid to start with slow roll rates and build from there. It's definitely much better to start slow and consistently progress rather than try to start with a very fast roll rate and get overwhelmed and discouraged very quickly. If you want an even greater talent, try doing rifle rolls in both left and right directions. You will find that even if you've learned one direction, switching to the other one, it's a pretty significant challenge at the beginning. I hope these tips were useful for your slow rolls and rifle rolls. In the future, I'll be looking into rolling Harriers, which build on some of the skills that we covered today. And we'll also be touching on how to change directions on rifle rolls in the future. Until then, happy flying!